Hey everybody, today we have Guy Renado, right?
Yes, that's right. So my name is Guy Renado, that's a French name, and my parents are also French. And I'm based in Amsterdam, and I'm also work a lot here in America, and especially in Los Angeles. So let's start to tell something about my studies, what I did. I went to university in Germany, in Cologne, and I did there piano and composition, and I did so two studies. And the school where I learn is a very famous school in Germany, and all the big classical guys have to teach there, or it's like Bain in Britain, all those famous guys, Frank Martin, so they have studied there. So it's also Stockhaus, they have also teach there and study there. So it's a very famous school there, and to enter the school, and that's maybe something new for you, there are 2,000 people try to get in at university, and only 200 will be invited, and only 2 will be admitted. Wow. And I was lucky that I was one of the two. Wow. And okay, you know, you have also other good guys, you know, so I had a bit of luck, you know, yes, to get admitted. And I got extra subvention from the Dutch government to study there. So the classes were very small. And that was a start, you know. It was a very good start, a very good study also. But you know, what I studied was real composition, to make pieces for big orchestra, to write pieces for concert, pianist, etc., opera, that kind of music. And I think was the year that I finished my studies. I met a guy, and he was more into the movies. And he asked me, "Guy, can you write something for movies?" So I love movies, you know. I think it's great, you know. But you know, I had no experience at all to write for movies. And okay, then I started. And then I had an opportunity to do some extra master together with Conrad Pope. And Conrad Pope, he's the orchestrator from John Williams, and he did Harry Potter, Star Wars, and this, all these big things. And he was one of my teachers. And another teacher was Joe Kramer, and he did Mission Impossible and Jack the Reacher. Wow. So big guys, you know, absolutely, and great teachers. So I learned exactly how to write, you know, for movies. And then, you know, I started, you know, I started also with the short movies and future movies and so. And then, you know, every game, you know, then you become bigger and bigger, and, you know, you have bigger projects and so on. So, and then I had the opportunity to work with some big directors. The first one is Paul Verhoeven. And Paul Verhoeven did also some movies like Elle. This was also in Cannes 2 years ago. And he did also, yeah, a lot of Turks Fruit, a lot of Dutch movies. Basic Instinct, he did also Basic Instinct. So he's a very famous Dutch director, and he's living also in LA. And so for me, he was the real big guy, you know, to enter also in the States, because, you know, when you're coming from Europe and you're going into the States, you know, it's something different, you know, a different culture. So he introduced me also here, and a lot of friends also told me, "Yeah, Guy, you have to go to America." And I said, you know, okay, Paul told me also that I have to go to America, because here in America you have Hans Zimmer, you have all the big guys and so, and what I'm doing in America, you know, I can better stay in Amsterdam, it's cool. Yeah. So in 2014, it's only 5 years ago, I went to the American film market, and I had a very good preparation. So I have some contacts online with some directors, and they really love my music because, you know, my style of writing is different than Hans Zimmer. And what you hear here in America, I will say not everybody, but a lot of people are clones from Hans Zimmer. And we in Europe, we have a different style of writing, mm-hmm. and the directors like this because, you know, every director want to have something special for the movies, mm-hmm. and that's also why, you know, composers from Iceland are now very popular also here in America, mm-hmm. because, you know, they have a different sound and different approach and so. And the advantage what I have is I can write really European, you know, but, you know, because I did also my studies with Conrad Pope, I can also write in an American way. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I know both cultures, and that's very handy because, you know, as a composer, you have to fill in the screen. So first you have to spot. First you have spotting sessions, mm-hmm. with the director, and then you're going to discuss where to put the music on the screen. And then, okay, you have to start from blank, you know, you have a blank page, you have nothing, and you have only dialogues, mm-hmm. and nothing else. And then you start writing, and then after a while, you know, it depends. Sometimes it's it takes you months, mm-hmm. sometimes it takes you longer, mm-hmm. and then when you are ready, at the moment, you have a second rendezvous with the director, mm-hmm. and then you discuss also the other things for the movie, so more fine-tuning kind of things. So discuss also with the director brings me also an idea. I think it's a very good thing to know more about what other people are doing. Mm-hmm. So I did some master classes, camera, you know, I was the only not camera guy, and there was master classes, everybody was a camera guy, you know, film industry, and we worked with big red cameras and so, and I worked with them, you know, and there I've learned, you know, how a camera guy can make a good movie, and how is the vision of a camera guy. I did also with acting lessons. I did also some acting lessons. So how can you analyze an actor or an actress? You know, that's also writing. And so, okay, my main thing is composing music, but, you know, of my bright interest about film, I learned also a lot of other things, and that makes, you know, that when you are dealing with a director, you understand much more better what the director is saying. And that's very handy because, you know, I do 2 to 4 movies a year, mm-hmm. so I have a lot of contacts with the director, mm-hmm. and it depends, you know, sometimes it's a thriller, then it's drama, then it's a comedy, mm-hmm. and then it's animation. So, and every director is different. So, and you have to understand very quickly because a big movie, like a future movie, mm-hmm. they have worked sometimes 5 to 10 years on the movie, mm-hmm. and also in the movie, the last 6 months. And in these 6 months, you have to understand the script, you have to understand the director, you have to compose the music, you have to do everything. Mm-hmm. So the quickest that you are understanding the movie and write the script and do a good analyze, the director will be more patient with you with the music because, you know, he knows exactly, this guy knows exactly what I mean, you know, and he tried to understand me and to put the right music on the screen, and that's very handy. And that's why, you know, a lot of directors ask me to do the movies. And what I like the most about making film music, and that's the point, why did I choose to make film music instead of concert music? So I'm writing also still concert music for big artists also, And I wrote also opera also. But you know what I like about film music? It's a kind of family. And because, you know, when you are a composer, you're sitting alone in the studio, and sometimes it's very boring, you know. Yeah, so you are still working for a year or 6 months on a piece, and then, you know, you go to a symphony orchestra, and you shake hands, and then your piece is going to be heard in the concert hall, and that's it, you know. And with film music, you are part of the team. Okay, the music is not so important as a concert, but you know, you are part of the team, and the challenge is to make the movie nicer, you know, to keep emotion more approachable, you know, when people are crying, it's not only for the actor, but also the music into it, because, you know, with the music, even with a bad movie and good film music, you can lift up the film. I've done a couple of shorts also in the past, and I was, you know, the movie was not so great, but the people loved it because of the music, because the music was so into it, and then the actors will also grow, because, you know, when you hear the music, you're gonna feel something, and you can also see a horror when you take, for example, an old movie from Hitchcock, mm-hmm. and one of my heroes is Bernard Herrmann, mm-hmm. and and he was a big composer from Hitchcock, the Hitchcock films, and he's from Vienna, and he went also to Los Angeles, mm-hmm. but you know, that's a long, long time ago, and I think it was in the 40s or the 30s, you know, from last century. And thus, you know, I really, really love also, you know, how we deal also with Hitchcock, because Hitchcock in Europe is a big name, you know. He was the first one with experimental kind of lighting and so on, and also his storytelling and to try to make, but also the movies he made was also the big part of the movie is also the music, and everybody knows the movie Psycho, mm-hmm. and Psycho, there's one scene with a shower, and Hitchcock won't have any music in the shower. He said, no, I think the shower will be only a woman, and she will be killed, and without music. And Bernard Herrmann, he was a composer, and he was also the composer of that movie. He said, you know, I can hear music here. And Hitchcock said, no way, because Hitchcock, you know, is a big guy, you know, he has kind of view. So. But Bernard Herrmann, he was also, you know, a guy, you know, he really has some very good idea. And Hitchcock agreed and said, okay, let's put some music into it. Mm-hmm. And then he composed something really ugly, you know, it's only string, you know, and everybody in the studio will say, you know, that's not music, that's horrible, you know, it's horrible to hear. And that's the big hit of that movie, and everybody knows that scene, because Bernard Herrmann really knows and feels how to put the right music on that scene. And I think that's one of the most important things of a composer, not to sing only about music, but you know, what kind of music did this picture or that scene or something need? And sometimes it's only sound design, and sometimes you have to do something with a big orchestra and so, but you know, you are part of the movie, and you have to feel the movie, and the audience will like it, because you know, you can immediately hear that the composer was understanding the movie. And what I suggest to every other composer or people who try to be a composer or something like that, try to read good scripts. Mm-hmm. Try also to see good films, make a lot of analyze about movies, and try to understand film. Mm-hmm. And then try to make nice music. Because you know, the film is the most important thing, and then secondly is the thing. And on with the soundtrack, you have the platform, you know, you have the opportunity to show yourself. You know, yes. You can, what's the title, you can do whatever. So that's one other thing I have to say. Now these days, you know, the budget is always a big problem, because you know every director try to put down the money and so, and you are in the post production and say, you know, oh, we have spent so much money, it's impossible and so. And I think that Hans Zimmer was the first one which did it, because Hans Zimmer is an old guy from a totally other generation, mm-hmm. but he was the first one. He was capable to let hear the music for the screen in the studio, and John Williams was not. You know, he was playing on the piano, and on YouTube you have a very nice thing about Jaws, mm-hmm. and he's playing the tune. And the director said, you know, listen, John Williams, this is a very serious movie, and we cannot deal with do. And that's a big hit, you know, because you know, everybody knows when this big fish come, is coming, that the tune do. That's amazing, you know, that grips you into the movie. So, what I'm doing is the same as Hans Zimmer. So what I'm doing is to compose everything in the studio, and when they're in Europe or when I'm in LA, so they can hear it live. Otherwise, you know, I will send it to the director, and then he can really feel the music, how it will be in the movie. Because, you know, for a director, sometimes mm-hmm. it's very hard, because, you know, not every director have knowledge about music, you know. There are some, they know everything about music, or they really love music. And there are some, you know, they have no idea about music, but the only thing they want to have is something to feel the vibe, you know, from music, so that the picture will be bigger and more interesting to watch. So, and the handy thing about this is what I'm doing, personally what I'm doing, I'm composing the music for 90%. And then I said to the director, we have to meet in Los Angeles or in Europe or something like that. And then we're going to sit together in the studio, and it's last 10% we do it together. Because, you know, sometimes it happens that a director want to change something. You know, we have a kind of scene, and I'm feeling this and this and this. And with media and so on, it's very handy, because, you know, when a director, and sometimes it's a little thing, you know, it's only about emotion, so. So they can change, you know, I can change, you know, something, and that's close. And the handy other thing is about orchestrating, because, you know, sometimes you have big budget films, and I have to go to Abbey Road in London, and then, you know, you have 80 people, sometimes 100 people, violinist, trumpet, and everything. There's a whole orchestra in front of you, and you have to print all the scores and so. And then the thing has to be closed. So what I'm doing is when the director is happy with the music, I say to him, okay, you are happy. Now I will close everything, and then I will put everything on paper. I go to Abbey Road or to Prague, you know, it depends only on the money. And then we go to the studio, everything is recorded, go to Pro Tools, and then go to the final edit. And then you have the big orchestra. And because that tip I got also from Hans Zimmer. Mm-hmm. In the time from Hans Zimmer, he had also a big problem, because, you know, the director was happy with the music. And when they started to directing the orchestra, and the director was hearing the music, he said, you know, I think it has to be a bit faster. And Hans Zimmer said to him, you know, guy, it's impossible, because, you know, those guys are only playing what is mentioned on paper, so you cannot change. Okay, and Hans Zimmer is a big guy, you know, he has a lot of experience, so he had enough power to say also to the director, okay, guy, man, we're gonna record like this, and then he was happy, you know. So I think 2019, I think this generation now we are into it. It's very handy for the whole market because you know it makes you more flexibility to do a lot of things. So that's about music. Maybe I can tell one thing more because I'm also a producer of movies, and they just asked me before I came from Amsterdam. They asked me to do this movie.
Yeah,
new project. So yeah, that's a totally new project, and you are the first one to hear about this. And that's a very interesting thing. It's a psychological thriller, and interesting about this is it is about a woman, and she went. To Bates, that is a little village above Amsterdam. Yeah, are you finished?
I'm checking.
Above Amsterdam, and she discovered also that its little villages in Holland are the same. They have the same drugs problem and the same thing. Then there was also in the big cities. In the past, so she went there and was a very great nature. I can show you here.
Yes,
that's how.
Show the camera. Yeah.
This one, you know, you can see it's very gentle. You know, you have farmers and so, and the nature is really great. You know, it's a really really great nature there, and so the story is about, you know, she's riding her teeth and she was looking out of the window, and she discovered a lot of things about villages, and it's only 30 miles from Amsterdam, so it's near Amsterdam, and the young people have low education there, and that's why they stay in the villages, and she was there, and also party, you know, it's a kind of party, that's a village party, and people talk about someone was murdered, and was a really a pretty one. So they murdered the guy, they cut him in pieces, and they put him in the oven. This she was thinking it's a very old story, maybe 10, 20 years ago, but you know, that was a story only 2 months ago.
Wow.
And that's a crazy story. And then she discovered also that the whole drugs problems are not in Amsterdam, but you know, more in the villages, and that's a huge problem now in the Netherlands, that you have gangs and that kind of thing in villages. You know, not, you know, the cities are quiet, you know, and it's more the south of Holland and the north of Holland. That's quite different. So it will be a very a thriller kind of thing, and that's very it's very unique, you know. I think it's more an art house kind of movie, and it's nice to that somebody is coming from a city, go into the village because she loves nature, and then she discovers how different that the people can be. Only was a distance with 30 miles, you know, and then you know she will discover a lot of things, and that's a very interesting thing. And so we will work on this. They asked me here as a producer, so it's totally new, and we have only the log line and the synopsis about this, and I like it very much, and I'm gonna also compose the music for it. And there's other movies, you know, they are still doing, that's more action movie. It's from Elusive Network, is Gabriel Di Costella. He's the director, Seasons of Rage, and this movie is a big budget movie. It's a 20 million movie, and I have to compose the music for it in 2 months. So I have to start in 2 months, and that's about the drugs problem in Mexico and also in Los Angeles. So
wow.
That's crazy. Yeah. So You know, it's an amazing script and I love it, and amazing team, and
Well, you heard it here first, Lon Key's new project.
Yeah, sure.
We're looking forward to seeing that.